So we have these 9 balls right over here, and we're going to assume that they are completely identical, at least they're identical in appearance, but one of the 9 balls is heavier, just a little bit heavier, is heavier than the other 8 balls. And my question to you is, what's the minimum number of times that we can use this scale in order to know definitively which is the heavier ball? So there's some number of weighings using the scale that after that number of weighings, I know for a fact that I found the heavier ball. We're not going to do something based on luck that you just happen to pick the right ball when you weigh it. It has to be 100% chance after this number of weighings that you have the ball. And so what is the minimum number of those, what is the minimum number of weighings of using this scale? And I encourage you to pause the video and think about it as long as necessary to come up with your own conclusions. So I'm assuming you've given a go at it, so I'll give you a couple of hints now. So my first hint is that you can do it in exactly 2 weighings of the scale. If I do 2 weighings of the scale, I know for a fact that I can find, not just through luck, I can find definitively the heavier ball. So that's my first hint, and if that helps you, I'll pause the video. I'm about to give you another hint. So my second hint is that with each weighing of the scale, you should be able to rule out 2/3 of the balls that are essentially still candidates for the heavier ball. So if that helps you, once again, pause the video. So now I'm assuming you've had a go at it, and maybe you were able to figure it out, maybe you weren't. So now let's work through it together. So I mentioned that in each weighing, you can rule out 2/3 of the balls. So how do we do that? So in the first weighing, what we essentially do is take our 9 balls and put it into 3 groups of 3. And we take 2 of those groups of 3. So we take this group, let me actually do that in a different color. So we can take this group of 3 right over here, put those 3 balls on that side of the scale, and then we could take these 3 balls and put it on that side of the scale. And so you're essentially weighing 3 versus 3 balls. Now, there's a couple of outcomes here. You're either going to have a balance, you're going to have the left is heavier, so let me write that, say it's going to tip down, so the left is heavier, or the right is heavier, or the right is heavier. Now what does each of these tell you? Well, if they balance, that tells you that this third group has the heavy ball. So actually, let me write it this way. If this is group 1, group 2, group 3, then this tells you that group 3 has heavy ball, has heavy ball. If the left is heavier, then we know group 1 has heavy ball, has the heavy ball. Group 1 has the heavy ball. And then finally, of course, if the right is heavier, we know that group 2 has the heavy ball. Now just like that, with one weighing, we have narrowed it down to one of the 3 groups. We've essentially narrowed it down. We now know that our heavy ball is 1 of 3 balls. It's either one of these 3, one of these 3, or one of these 3. And so I just repeat the process, but instead of doing it with 3 balls at a time, I now do it with 1 ball at a time. So if I'm taking 3 balls, if I have 3 balls, what I could do is I will now, so my step 2, I guess I could say, my step 2, I now weigh 1 versus 1. And once again, I have the outcomes. So if they are balanced, then that means so once again, if we're taking, say, this group of 3, we're in the balanced situation from the first weighing. And so if we put this ball here and this ball here, if they are balanced, then we know that this must be the heavy ball because these 2 are the same. If the left goes down, then we know this is the heavy ball. And likewise, if the right goes down, we know that this is going to be the heavy ball. So this is actually a little bit of a brain teaser that you see. It's a pretty common one. It's actually even sometimes you'll hear it in some job interviews. But you could see it comes out of the idea that through each weighing, you can rule out 2/3 of the balls. And so you could use this principle if you want to derive other brain teasers. What if you had 27 balls? How many weighings would you need? What if you had 81? And sometimes when you see this brain teaser, instead of giving you a nice, clean, I guess you could say power of three right over here, they might give you something off. So they might give you eight balls. But the exact same principle holds. If you had eight balls, you could split it up into two groups of three, and then two more, and then do the same, and then do the exact same process. But I think people like to do the eight balls because it takes you a little away from the idea of maybe you have to divide it into groups of three or something like that. Anyway, hopefully you have enjoyed this.